In the subject of segregation, the East has scored a big propaganda bullseye. Judge for yourself.
Violent clashes have taken place in Alabama, where segregationists, with the connivance of the state authorities, are making brutal attacks on demonstrators. The scenes of bloodshed in Montgomery are reminiscent of the worst examples of savagery. In Montgomery, on Saturday, crowds of enraged segregationists made a brutal attack on 21 Negroes and white people protesting against the anti-Negro laws. The streets were a scene of bloodshed. According to eyewitnesses, it was a terrible sight. It is also reported that one Negro was left lying in the streets in a pool of blood. The crimes of Bloody Saturday have the blessing of Governor John Patterson of Alabama. He took no steps to prevent the outrage and gave instructions to the police not to intervene. A characteristic feature of Bloody Saturday in Montgomery was that the racists turned on the reporters, particularly press photographers and cinema operators, who tried to take pictures of the scenes of brutality. Norman Ritter, reporter from Life and Time, was among those beaten up. These magazines are always trying to persuade their American and non-American readers how democratic and free everything is in the United States. It's difficult to guess what they will tell their readers now. It will have to be admitted that the members of this Peace Corps have a pretty difficult task. Who is going to believe their propaganda after what has happened in Alabama?
While five whites and two Negroes were being arrested in Jackson for riding in the same bus, while fascist thugs were carving a swastika on the living body of a Negro student in Sumter, South Carolina, publicity experts at a convention in Washington were being reproached for their failure to show the world the real America. They were told they have not been able to play up American humanitarianism, integrity, and democracy. They can advertise American cornflakes and automobiles because they really are good, but how can they make the African Negroes sympathize with the unpunished beatings of American Negroes in Mississippi and Louisiana, the use of tear gas against them, the burning of their buses in Alabama, the torture of Herman Harris in South Carolina, and the unjust sentences passed on Negroes in Jackson? Don't you know that freedom is a bad word in the state of Mississippi?
In your country yesterday, the people whom the courts convicted were not the racists, Ku Klux Klan conspirators, or fascists who murdered Negroes and burned their houses and cars, but the Negroes themselves and those white citizens who would no longer tolerate the barbarous practice of discriminating against people whose skin was another color to theirs. The people who were sent to jail were not the thugs who beat up and kicked the Negroes of Montgomery, but Mr. and Mrs. Gatch, who, horrified by the brutality, implored the police who were standing by to intervene. These two citizens were actually convicted of committing a breach of public order, so that the court evidently wished to show that beating up people in the streets is public order in Alabama. As reported by the New York Herald Tribune, the local police in Montgomery have membership in the Ku Klux Klan, and the atmosphere is such that people talk about the fight against segregation in whispers. Thus, the Negroes of Alabama are now unprotected from the lawlessness of the racists, enjoying the support of the local authorities and the state troopers, half of which are Ku Klux Klan members. That was commentary by Leo Tichayev on the race riots in the state of Alabama. This is Radio Moscow.